So this verse, it's just the next verse which we read last week. Gauranga Sunda was giving us a nice introduction in this feeling of motherly love. That's why we are going on here. So Raghunath Das or Tulasi Manjari, Rati Manjari, is cuddled by the Queen of Braj. And she is kissing her head. You know how it is when you love your children, especially when they are small, they are smelling like milk on the head. And you smell and you are so satisfied in the heart. It's so drenching the heart. You cannot describe. Parents know. They will understand. This is the scene. So Yashoda Ma is embracing and kissing and smelling the head. Such a wonderful scene. We may meditate on that. And Mother Yashoda feels, because all mothers feel like that, she can feel who is the real match for her son. Every mother who is in feeling, who is in bath, she can feel who is the perfect match for the own son. She knows before the son knows. Because of her love, because of this connection, this loving exchange. So, of course, Mother Yashoda, she knows who is the perfect match. And that's why she feels like her newly married daughter-in-law, Radha, is her newly married daughter-in-law, full of fresh feelings of love, like it is always in Vrindavan, very fresh, very deep, like that. So, maybe someone wants to share some feelings on this verse before we go in the explanations. Please feel free to interrupt me at any moment when the inspiration comes. Let us share. This is Gurudev's wish, like a big salad of bhavas, but in one direction. Explanations. Sri Raghunath submits to Swamini's lotus feet. How severely his heart suffers for want of her. His desire to see her is also just for her pleasure, only to serve her, not for his own happiness. There is no deceitfulness in a pure, loving heart. And this love is most pure in Braj. When the Sadaka follows in the footsteps of Krishna's devotees in Braj, the rays of the moon of Raga Bhakti will be reflected in his crystal clear heart. Then love will be free from the sight. Outside of Braj, all forms of love of God are more or less mixed with the feelings of awe and reverence. Even in the appendix of Braj Lila, Navadvip Lila, an example is here, Ramananda Roy was, for instance, Vishakasaki in Braj. So he should have had pure fraternal love for Sriman Mahaprabhu. But when he met the Lord at the bank of the Godavari River, and their mutual love arose, Ram Roy could not take the Lord to his own home. The Vedic Brahmanas invited the Lord, and Rai respectfully told him, "Where are you, Lord Narayan? You are Narayan himself. And where am I? A royal servant and a lowly Shudra. You did not fear the Vedic injunctions by touching me, although the Vedas forbid you to touch me. Both in form and nature, you show all the symptoms of God. Such transcendental attributes are not possible in a mere living entity. This is written in Chaitanya Charit Amrita Matya Lila 8:43. But Krishna's friends in Braj eat his food and climb on his shoulder. Therefore, there is no other place but Braj which is free from any whiff of awe and reverence. Without allegiance to the people of Braj, there will inevitably come some Aishwarya Kyan, feeling of lordliness about Krishna. Sri Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the complete non-dual truth. And Sri Radha is the Supreme Goddess, Svayam Bhagavati, the complete Mahabhava. This is the tattva side of it. But we know But what we know is the rasa side. He is Sri Radha's prana bandhu.
Gaurabani?
Yes.
Can we shortly stop here?
Yes.
Because few points which are very important in this part of your reading and Baba's commentaries are given. You have some addition?
First you.
Because, yeah, all right. In the beginning of commentary, Baba is giving this very nice note and explanation that all Raghunatha's desire to see Radhika is not for her, his own pleasure, but for Radhika's pleasure. So it means that when he is suffering from separation of Radhika, he is not suffering because of himself. Deeply meaning of this suffering is that he is suffering because he cannot be near Radhika to serve her for her pleasure. And he knows that Radhika will be very happy that her Tulasi, Dasi, is with her. This is the suffering of Raghunath or Tulasi. So this is the very, very high stage of someone who cannot be only on the prema level, but must be immersed in Mahabhava. That is one point. Short to say.
Can you show the clip? Yes.
Yes.
And we can see here, Baba is continuing that this closeness, this kind of pure love without any deceitfulness, kevala bhakti, is possible only in Vraj. This is a place, proper place for expression, such kind of feelings. Every feelings, loving feelings, needs also proper place to be expressed. We all know from our lives, when we have been in love, automatically we searching for some romantic place to churn this love more. Someone likes mountains, some likes seaside, someone likes Venice, someone likes Paris or whatever. But the same principle is impure bhakti. This is importance of Raja, because such kind of exchange of love is not possible, and romantic love especially also is not possible in any place, even in Navadvip. Our acharyas are saying that there is no difference between Navadvip and Vrindavan. Actually, if we remember, we can see that Radhika made Navadvip for the Krishna's pleasure. But I don't want to go in this detail. The point is that acharyas are telling us that through Navadvip we can be qualified, or through Gaura Lila to be qualified, most of us, not everyone, but most of us, for Radha Krishna Lila. But Navadvip is the place also of awe and reverence. And if someone wants to be free from all this, he has to develop deep yearnings for Vrindavan. Because Vrindavan is the only place, Rajabhumi, is the only place where pure love can be manifested and expressed without any burden of Aishwarya. So I said like this, and please add something more, because this part is very important, because after that we will start, I think, to go in more rasik details.
Our Raghunath Bhaiya also wanted to say something.
Radhe, Radhe.
Radhe, Radhe.
Thanks to everybody there, and hope you're all fine and emerged in that beautiful words of our dear brothers. And wow. I just remember one thing, and that was when I always remember Srila Siddha Maharaj. I don't know. He's coming up all the time. Bhakti Rakshak Siddha Dev Goswami Maharaj. That when we were sitting with him together, and he was saying, always when we speak about tattva, there's one center point. And that center point is Krishna. And always when we speak about rasa or raga, then the center point is Radha. So that means when we consider, like before mentioned, the Ragatmikas, which is, for example, Mother Yashoda representing the motherly love, or Subali is representing the friendship, brotherly love and all this, then we immediately can feel and see that where's Radha there? And okay, you know where Radha is. Radha is it's her expansion. It's very nice because Radha wants to. The only desire is of Radha is she wants to make Mohan happy all the time. So Mohan is a trooper. He's running around everywhere. He's going into the forest, and he's going there and here. And so she needs an expansion equivalent, acquainted with that mood. So when he's running around in the forest and he's joining with all his friends and this and that, then you also can feel Radha in Balaram. She expands in Balaram. And she expands, like before Gauravani said so nicely, in the motherly love as Yashoda. So when we see what means actually Raga Bhakti, the explanation which was given by Silasira Maharaj was that the Ragatmikas are the ones who are representing a mood and who are really, let's say, the role models of that mood, like Mother Yashoda of motherly love and Subala of friendly love. So what that means is all the ones who follow this mood is called Raga Bhakti. Is that too fast or should I speak slower? Okay, so all who follows that Ragatmikas are called Raganugas. So there's a very nice point there because there is the different snehas. And if you go in our real bath, the Manchari bath means adik sneha. We are only focused in our heart on Radha. That's why she is making Mohan happy wherever she can do it. And we want to make Radha happy wherever we can do it. So that wonderful explanation there is, and also the feeling and what we can in our heart, deep in our heart feel is, and we only want to focus on Radha. There's nothing else anymore. So that manifests also in the Satagdeya. When you go back to your Satagdeya, then you also...
I don't have a connection. I was out. So if you can put me again in the translation room, please.
Continue.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay. Just continue or I wait?
Yeah, you can continue. Just they put me.
Okay. So if you want to make only Radha happy in the Satagdeya, how we can do this? That is the question. When we feel really our Raghunath Das Goswami is Vilapa Kusumanjali, he is showing it. Actually, it's impossible. Satagdeya means some conditions. But when we want to serve Radha without conditions, we have to be so close to that intense desire. We have to have that intense desire so deep rooted in us. Just one. Back there. Get it? Then we can do it in Manasi Seva. Manasi Seva means that what is beautiful means, hey, there's no escape anymore. And what can capture all this is love, because she's loving us so much, you know. She's standing there and she said, come all, come please, I wait for you, come right now. It doesn't matter, you're in the Satagdeya, no problem.
Radhe, it's a real money. Sorry.
I'm trying. I think we wait for Gopinath because he's not updating with my hand. Just give us a moment. It needs his hand somehow.
Okay.
Sorry, everyone. There's a lot going on parallel here, as always in Mungir Mandir.
Jai Ho, Radha.
Jai Radhe.
This is, we are locked down in unconditional love. That is actually, that is our lockdown. I just go on a little bit more with that, or I wait, or?
Yes, please go on, and when Gopinath come, we will be fixed. Thank you.
So that is a very nice meditation. This manaseva is also explained in manashiksha. And the manasiseva is becomes real. I mean, you're sitting in your sadhagdaya and you meditate about something. What are you right now doing there? So that connection, that is actually bhajan. This is the real bhajan, the most excellent bhajan. That you and your manasiseva, that you identify, with your real service, with your real seva to Radha. We have all our many, we know our seva already, but we have to, everybody knows it, not feels it. And that is actually the seva where we should be. And we should meditate. There's a lot to do, but everybody on his seva meditating, that is the highest expression, how you can connect from that dimension of time and space. That brings you from time and space to another dimension, to the fifth dimension, to the fifth node, which is unconditional love. And that sounds wonderful. We never have heard such a sound before. Beautiful. Yeah, here's a little bit like in a train station right now. I feel a little bit like in a train station. In a transcendental train station. So
here concentrate.
Comes the train, there comes the train, and wonderful. Yeah, this is what I the manasi seva, that absorption in your seva. And this is what you transcend the train station, can you imagine?
all to the same destination.
All to the same destination. Wow, so many.
So many things going on.
Yeah, what about, I mean, it's unconditional love and that's it.
Yes.
We don't have to. That is actually the point. If that awakens in the heart, if you desire that in your heart, it will be there. It will come with that. That is our nature. Like, I remember a nice song when he was singing. What was it? What was the title? A Trotarian was singing. I look at you all, see the love there that's sleeping. That's it. The love is sleeping. The unconditional love is sleeping in the heart. Just have to awaken it. That's it. And actually, I feel something. I never have thought that I would be able, I mean, I'm able for nothing, but I mean, just to can be here for so long time in a row. And there's happening something. I tell you, there's something happening. I really can recommend it to everybody. Stay a while here and then things happening. You cannot,
you cannot grasp anymore. You cannot study. You cannot, it's nowhere written. It's just one thing which is revealing in yourself and what is identifying you with the real thing, with your real identity. Because you are not so much more focused in the external things. It's coming internally. And internally, that develops and develops and develops and it manifests. And that is what I only can add with all my love for this. That Radha is so wonderful and so beautiful, and this Radhi Rasananda means that Mohan is meditating all the time in the lotus feet, in the effulgence of the lotus feet of Radha, and he's so absorbed in this, and he's only saying Radha. His parents sent him to meditate in Narayan. And he goes to the meditation room and he's looking around and he's saying, Radha. And the effect of that is that he sees her in the same moment. So he himself is showing the power of the name. And when you remember this verse, Namo Chintamani, Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. So Chaitanya in this Namo Chintamani is like the holy name, is like a wish fulfilling gem. And Chaitanya is here translated as full of ecstasy. Chaitanya, the name of Chaitanya is translated in this verse, full of ecstasy. And that's it. This is what is Chaitanya actually representing, total ecstasy. That is, at one side it is Radhi, this Radhi Rasanandan and Radhi Rasanandan Samohitas. That means that all what hears Radharani from the Manjaris, that is the same feeling like Krishna has when he hears from about Radha. Yeah, Dade.
We'll try to connect the translation.
We try to connect so many things.
Please continue reading.
Yeah.
Yes, please. It's arrangement. What can we do?
O Empress of Vrindavan, Sri Radhike, please make Keshiripu pitifully pray to me for your audience. The sweet mood towards Krishna, totally free from awe, is nowhere else to be found but in the shelter of Sri Radha's lotus feet. Srila Rupa Goswami shows that even in Braj, there is more awe and reverence felt by Chandravali then by Sri Radhika. Utshvalanilamani Stai 91 states, Chandravali takes her left arm from Krishna's shoulder while they are dancing in the Rasa festival and embraces him with her right arm instead. Carefully and crookedly she moves both her feet, being afraid that she will hit Krishna's feet while they are danced together. Seeing this, all the other young girls laugh. How freely and sweetly our Swamini dances. How freely and independently she lifts her feet upon Shyam's chest. Sri Rupa says, I am a maid servant of that Radha. That's why Shyam is simply wandering behind me. In Kashi, Benares, Sriman Mahaprabhu and Sanatan Goswami embraced each other to the astonishment of Chandrasekhar. Sri Gauranga had just returned from Vrindavan and was in the ecstasy of Virahini, separated. Virahini, the separated Radha from Krishna. And Sri Sanatan Goswami was absorbed in his Siddha Swarup of Labanga Manjari. Both were absorbed in their previous moods. But as soon as they returned to external consciousness, the mood of awe and reverence returned. Sanatan then said, Oh my Lord, don't touch me. And the Lord said, I am touching you to purify myself. On the strength of your devotion, you can purify the whole universe. The service of Sri Radha is Sriman Mahaprabhu's gift and was taught by himself and by the acharyas who surrendered to his lotus feet. When one's Siddha Swarup awakens, feelings of separation from Sri Radha will become very strong.
Diventano molto forti. Io voglio vederti.
Sorry, there was a problem with the translation room. I have to put everyone again in. I'm very sorry.
Oh, die Übersetzung ging gar nicht.
Die Übersetzung ging bis jetzt. Ich habe es jetzt nur ausschalten müssen.
I just had okay, gut. Okay, warte. Sorry.
Maybe a small kirtan, Raghunath.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's more kirtan in the meantime.
So sorry. I don't know what happened, but.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare.
Too much love, technology cannot handle.
Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Hare.
Nobody, I cannot bring anyone in. What happened to Ramani? What happened to him?
He can relish the sweet sight of how Mother Yashoda sweetly cuddles Swamini. After eating, Swamini takes a little rest. Then Ma calls her and Tulasi brings her to Mother Yashoda, who tightly embraces her, cuddles her, kisses her, and smells her head as if she is her own newly married daughter-in-law. Again and again, Mother holds Swamini's chin and looks in her eyes, floating in her own loving tears. With choked voice, Mother Yashoda says, "Oh, my girl, without you, my whole life is dark. Don't forget to come here always." Sri Radhika may be respectful to Mother Yashoda, but her control over her son is complete. Nobody can deal so freely with Krishna as she can. Sri Radhika has no such fears and worries about stepping on Krishna's feet. Because of her supreme love for him, she can do with him whatever she likes. She even puts her feet on his chest if she likes. "When will I see you like that?" Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj writes in Govinda Lilamrita 4.7 to 71, filled with affectionately eager desires to marry her son, Yashoda carefully placed many suitable ornaments in excellent baskets at her home, as if Sri Radhika was her newly married daughter-in-law. Danishta brought these baskets to Sri Radhika along with betel leaves, sandal paste, vermilion, and new garments. Queen Yashoda was very happy to see Sri Radhika surrounded by her friends, as if she was her own newly married daughter-in-law. At this time, Danishta will arrange for a short meeting of Radha and Krishna in the Giri Nikunja at Nandishwara. Sri Raghunath Das Goswami described that in his Stavavali. I worship Radha and Krishna's dearmost girlfriend Danishta, who joyfully arranges with different tricks for Sri Radha and Krishna's meeting in the Giri Nikunja of Nandishwara. After Sri Radha was brought to Nandishwara in the morning by Yashoda, the Queen of Braj, to cook for Krishna. This Yogapit Leela goes along with the devotee's mantra smarana. The regular smarana of a fixed devotee continues like a stream throughout the day. But the mantra smarana that occurs in between is compared to a lake within that stream. The river stream of regular smaran passes on through this lake after the mantramayi upasana. Sri Haripat Srila sings, O Radhe, whose eyes are restless as a wagtail bird, you are the crown jewel of Krishna's lovers. How affectionately the Queen of Braj is looking at you, soothing her own heart by embracing you and holding you to her chest. Saying, Oh, Vinodini, you are the very form of auspiciousness for King Nanda's abode. She smells your head. Carefully, Yashomati cuddles you as if you are her newly married daughter in law. When will my heart be filled with ever new feelings of pride, when I see Vrajeshwari's love for you, which is like a great festival of glory. O Kanchanakshi, girl with eyes as restless as a wagtail bird's, when will I feel a great festival of joy in my heart? When I see you being cuddled by the Queen of Braj, who embraces you, kisses your head, and lovingly stares at you as if you are her newly married daughter-in-law. Jai Shri Radhe.
Radhe Radhe.
Thank you, Gauravani. Gauravani, the beginning explained this addressing Ratarani Kanchanakshi like a restless eye girl who is always in the search for Krishna. There is also a deeper meaning, another meaning. Which is connected with situation. In one sense, Radhika is very shy, in front of Yashoda, but in the heart, she is burning. When will I see my Nagara? So she's blinking with her eyes, asking the help of her girlfriends. Find some solution. Be intelligent. Help me to distinguish this fire in my heart. And then the Nishtha is finding solution for this beautiful yoga pit. So these secret signs to her girlfriends, maidservants, makes Radhika Kanchanakshi very restless and in the same time very shy in the presence of Yashoda. And what's happened? Near, very close, near Nandishwara, there is Giri Nikunja, like we heard. And it's very interesting that this Giri Nikunja is completely unknown to Yashoda, Nanda Baba, and all elders. Only Radhika, her maidservants and girlfriends knows for existence of this Giri Nikunja, secret place in Nandishwar. And this is the moment when Radhika and Krishna are coming together secretly, and Baba is saying, this is yoga pit, place of meeting. Gauravani, can you explain us, please, this difference between Swarasika Upasana and this Mantra Smarana? You can read again to continue to remember devotees. Is it okay for you?
I can read again.
Yes, please. Just the regular Smarana. Yes. In the bottom of 260 page. The regular Smarana is fixed of fixed devotee and so on and so on.
The regular Smarana of a fixed devotee. So this Yogapit Lila goes along with the devotee's mantra, Smarana, which is the meditation on one's initiation mantra. The regular Smarana of a fixed devotee continues like a stream. Svarasik Upasana throughout the day. But the mantra smarana, mantra mai upasana, that occurs in between is compared to a lake within that stream. Well, it's a wonderful picture. Because if you flow with a stream, then maybe the stream is in between going into a lake and afterwards out of the lake. Like in Germany, we have a big sea, Bodensee, it's like that. Rhine is coming inside, one side flowing through the sea, and on the other side it's going out. And then it gets wild again. So the stream is the meditation in the seva. So whatever you do is connected with the seva of Radharani. This is going out 24/7. It's a stream just going on, but the sea, like a how you say, a pool, or big pool of water, is your meditation on your initiation mantras in between. So all in all, it's an expansion of this stream, and it gives peace to the ongoing stream. But I think you have some special thing on your mind, Gauranga Sundara, so please share with us. I want to learn.
I just want to say that these two types of meditation is actually like Lila Smarana, where so many things are inside of this lila. For example, to be practical, for example, when devotee is meditating on this lila in Nandishwara, how Radhika came in Nandishwara, how she's cooking, how she's serving, how she is in situation very close to Mother Yashoda, This is some continuation of Lila. But in the moment when Radhika meet with Krishna, Yogapit, then this is a beautiful lake in the middle of the stream of Lila. So this is mantra, Mayi. When devotees stop meditation on whole Lila and he is fixed in details of their loving meeting or yoga pit. So we have, let's say, global meditation on global Lila, and this is specific details when Radha and Krishna are together, or this place is yoga pit. So this is my also understanding. Maybe someone can correct me. Because why is important? If we meditate only on Lila, especially if we try to follow this Ashtakalya Lila in the proper time, what's going on, what's happening, it's like a stream. But it can be trap to come in the Vaidhi Bhakti. I'm looking in my watch and I said, oh, now is the 12 o'clock. Now is going this Lila and now I will meditate what's happening then. Oh, now is the 3 o'clock. I will meditate what's happening in a 3 o'clock. And when we start to do this, always careful and watchful to meditate according to the time and specific Lila, we will lose our raga. That's our Gurudev explained to me. So this is the reason why I'm talking this. And this general Lila, this general stream of Lilas, which is going on 24 hours a day, is a description of what's going on in Vrindavana. To get taste, to get some attachment, attraction for meditation. But in one point, we have to leave this to Radhika, to mantra, to bring us what they want. So this is general information. Gurudev told me, this is general information to think like Ashtakalya Lila. But whatever comes to your mind, just go in that flow. And when Yoga Pit appears, then stop. That's it. Radhe Radhe.
Thank you. Гаурасундари очень жизненно и человечно объяснил. Нандарани, переведите, пожалуйста.
Yes, we can hear you.
Вас не слышно, да?
Yes. We can hear you.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, it's very bad connection, sir. I don't hear anything. I don't catch the point. I don't understand.
Rani, could you... Yeah, now we can hear you. Yeah. We can hear you. How the others, Goravani? You
no.
can hear?
No, I cannot hear Nandarani.
Oranga Sundar, you can hear? Can
I can hear you?
Sorry. Не стоит, Нандарани, скажите, что не стоит. Гауранга Сундар, вы сказали очень человечно и жизненно, ну, очень понятно, спасибо, thank you, спасибо. Wonderful, beautiful.
Okay, I understand, спасибо, хвала, thank you, okay.
Хвала, хвала.
Thank you too, Baba. Thank you too, хвала, all right. Спасибо. Yeah.
Jaho.
Gopinath, you hear me?
Yes, my dear, we're here. One second. We just have parallel, we're listening Spanish.
I think that's...
We have Spanish translation.
Maybe it's time. If no one has some special sharing what really he wants, maybe it's time to stop. Because it's really, really difficult. It was very difficult for Goravani also to go on the flow. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I don't know what happened today. Maybe we are a bit... I don't know what... I have no words, so sorry. It's a big storm outside and maybe... Maybe the storm. And now Raghunath wants to have the concluding remarks.
Oh, all right. That's good.
Rade. Okay. So I just want to connect with the words. Oh my God, I hear me three times. You hear me? Rade? Oh my God. Rade? I hear me like...
Yes. Yes, I hear you.
Nandarani, listen.
Yes, we hear you.
Anyway, to make it short, what I feel is that to connect with the words, these beautiful words of Gauranga Sundar, and just to say that when we are in that meditation of times, and when we see only... I sit down here, my God. Rade. Again. So, okay? So when we meditate about times, that means also we condition our consciousness, because we are in the we automatically put ourselves in time and space. Okay, so that means, in short, that means we try to understand tattva vichar.
this is actually tattva vijab, when we start to grasp through some experience in time and space, something which is beyond time and space. That means all what is impossible, let's put it this way, what is impossible in tattva vichar, that is possible in rasa vichar. So when we are really in meditation, really in deep meditation, and when we are in that, we're in the flow, that has nothing to do with our conditions of this time and space, then we are really in something which seems to be impossible, suddenly will be possible. And this is also a little bit like in our sadhakdeya, it seems actually impossible to get out of this, but as soon as you open your heart, as soon as you forget conditions of this world and everything, you open your heart into that and connect it with unconditional love, then you're in rasa vichar. And the impossible becomes possible. That means, actually, it's impossible to be in your swarup, but it is possible in rasa vichar. This is the only thing I wanted to add, Rade. It is possible right now, here and now, just identify with this, what is in rasa vichar, and then everything automatically comes in a flow. And that is that river which is going, like the river, I know I'm in Spanish, English. The river, so the river continues, it never stops, the water always continues. That is our inspiration in rasa vichar, Radhe Radhe. Everything will be revealed automatically without endeavor. Nothing to be endeavored. Nothing. Only that's it. We just feel it. Because that is feeling. That is feeling. That is path. That is anubhava. And the other thing is, you are in the head. You are in intellect and try to understand the things. And that's not good. That's good for nothing. That's only, we only stay in that tattva knowledge and qualification and this and that. And as soon as we have that intense desire to be unqualified and to be really connected, then we are in Radhe. Jai. Radhe, Radhe.
Radhe, Radhe. Thank you very much.
So, thank you all.
Dan, Radhe, Radhe.
So happy to share with you. Radhe, Radhe.
Can I maybe just cook it down a little bit? Because I'm a very simple-minded person, and I try to understand in very simple manners. So I was just thinking, like my children, when they were in a playing room, some things are impossible what they want to play. They cannot reach the goal alone. But when the parents come, everything will be possible because the parents can show. So if they just have the wish and are crying for the mother, everything will come. So easy. Is that right? Thank you all my brothers, sisters.